as you know the indication of the forceps, fetal distress is the commonest in second stage of labor, and there is again prolonged second stage of labor, maternal exhaustion, and these are the commonest indications. So I'm going to apply the forceps. For the forceps, you have to keep the forceps and the other normal delivery instrument. Then you prepare yourself for putting the personal equipment and then the gloves. Before that, you have already done the periabdominal examination, maternal condition, about the uterine contractions. Now, do the part preparation, cleaning, and catheterization, evacuation of the bladder. Thereafter, you assess, do the PV examination. Cervix must be the fully dilated, fully effaced. Head should be in, and sagittal suture is anterior-posterior direction, and head should be below plus 2 station. How will you assess? You do the PV examination and palpate the ischial spine. Head will be below the ischial spine. And already I told you, you do the periabdominal examination. If any of the colon is palpable, never apply forceps. Then you take the forceps. How will you identify which side of the forceps? Put the tip of the forceps towards the maternal head. And then this is the concavity is there. This is the pelvic curve. And this is cephalic curve. This is the cephalic curve. This is the pelvic curve. So tip is towards the maternal head. Pelvic curve concavity is towards the upward. So this forceps, this is corresponding to the right side of the mother, so it is right blade, and it is corresponding to the left side of the mother, it is left blade. So first of all, you assemble the blade that it is fit. There is nothing wrong with the forceps. Thereafter, you take the left blade. Left blade, you lubricate the blade, and then you insert your two finger of the right hand inside the lateral pelvic wall, between the lateral pelvic wall and fetal head. Hold the left blade, pen holding position, and it is parallel to the left inguinal ligament, and insert this blade between your finger and the fetal head. And insert, it will go easily. Then you ask the assistant, sometime required, sometime, you depress it and ask the assistant to hold the blade. Now you take the right blade, again lubricate it, hold it in the right hand, and introduce your lateral pelvic wall and the fetal head. And then it is parallel to the right inguinal ligament, and insert between these two. When you are inserting this, it should go easily. Now it will lock easily. The right blade is above the left blade. Right blade is above the this right blade is above the left blade. And then you give the traction with the uterine contraction. When there is the uterine contraction are there, you give the horizontal traction. And sometimes either you give the perineal pressure, you can ask the assistant to give a pressure. Now if there is the stretching of the perineum, you can give the episiotomy, medio-lateral episiotomy. Because you have given the local anesthesia before applying the forceps. Now you give the horizontal traction, then forward and upward. Then you remove, as soon as the head is delivered by the extension, you remove the right blade first, then left blade, and then you deliver the baby same way as in the normal delivery by the lateral traction. Now you palpate the uterine abdomen, there is no second baby, then ask the assistant, give the 10 units of oxytocin with the birth of the baby. And then put the baby and you clean it, and baby is crying, there is no need of resuscitation, then put it on the abdomen of the mother. And then you palpate the uterus. Uterus is well contracted. with a controlled co-attraction method, you deliver the placenta. Uterus is contracted by the controlled co-attraction method. You are delivering the placenta, and after delivering, as soon as the placenta comes on the vulva, you hold the placenta in the hand, and by the rotation and traction, you deliver all of its membrane and deliver out. Then put the placenta like this, see all the membrane, maternal surface of the placenta, and put it in the which bin? It will be go in the yellow bin. Thereafter, uterus is well contracted. When the uterus is well contracted, you slightly retract the vagina. You see there is any vaginal laceration or any bleeding is from the vagina. Then, if it is not there, then you stitch the episiotomy in three layer. First layer by the mucosa, second layer in the muscle, and third layer is the skin. Thereafter, clean the patient, make it comfortable, cover the patient and make it comfortable, put the baby on the mother breast. All the instrument should be put in the 0.5% bleaching solution for the decontamination, and all the cotton, soap and in the respective bin you have to put. Then put your hand in the bleaching solution, rub it and take out the glove by inside out, and then you wash your hand and do the documentation. So this is about the forceps delivery. Now it was in the Zoe. I can show you in also in the this pelvis also. This is the pelvis. This is the baby and head is there. So peritoneally you have seen that the head is gone down. There is none of the pole is palpable and head is visible at the vulva. It means it is a lower down. So you have to apply low forceps delivery. In this case, हो सकता है उसमें आपको बहुत अच्छे से नहीं दिखा हुआ, इसलिए हम डमी पेल्विस में भी दिखा रहे हैं, है ना? इसमें भी आप डमी पेल्विस में क्या करेंगे? इसमें भी आपने पहले पैराब्डोमिनली असेस कर लिया है, वेजाइनली असेस कर लिया है, प्रीरिक्विजिट पूरा हो गया. प्रीरिक्विजिट मींस सर्विक्स फुली डायलेटेड है, हेड इंगेज है, मतलब प्लस टू स्टेशन पे है. सजाइटल सूचर, सजाइटल सूचर जो है एंटीरियर पोस्टीरियर डायरेक्शन में है, एंड पेल्विस एडिक्वेट है, मेम्ब्रेन एब्सेंट है, ब्लैडर एम्प्टी है. इन दैट केस अगेन दिस इज द ब्लेड. समटाइम क्या है, आपने असेंबल करके देख लिया, ब्लड ब्लेड बिल्कुल ठीक है. अब आपको अलग से एक ब्लेड मिल गया, ये लेफ्ट है कि राइट है, कैसे पता लगेगा? सो टिप शुड बी द टुवर्ड द मदर. अपवर्ड, and the pelvic top is medial side. So this is the right blade and you lock it. Now the blade which is above, it is always right, and the blade which is lower, it is left blade. So if there is need of episiotomy or for the analgesia, you give the pudendal block or you infiltrate the 1% xylocaine at the proposed episiotomy site. Then you take the left blade, lubricate it, hold in left hand, apply on the left side of the mother. Put your two finger in lateral pelvic wall and the fetus and apply this forceps between your finger and the lateral pelvic wall. Then you can and depress it. You can ask to hold it. Then you take the right blade and apply on the right side, and same way it should go easily and easy lockdown. And then you give the horizontal traction. When there is the stretching of perineum, you give the episiotomy, medial lateral episiotomy. Then you can deliver the head like this. Head will be delivered by the extension. Now you take out the right blade first and left blade, and then you can deliver the baby by the lateral traction. Put the baby on the abdomen of the mother. After that, you cut the cord and do the active management of third stage of labor and deliver the placenta. So it's okay. Now it is the forceps delivery. Rest of the procedure should be done. Active management of third stage of labor, examination of the cervix and vagina for any tear and laceration, and there is no bleeding. Watch for the PPH. If there is no bleeding, repair the episiotomy and make the patient comfortable. And thereafter, proper disposal of instrument, gloves, and waste material. Thank you very much.